my name is Martina and I'm a textile designer based in Kensington, Maryland. Welcome to my studio. I'm really excited that you are coming in for a visit, even though it's only online. Let me tell you a little bit about how I work and why I am a textile designer. I do have a degree in fashion design, but I have always been much more mesmerized by the fabrics than the fashion themselves. So in graduate school, I got into fashion design and started my company called RADOST, which is the Czech word for joy. That's my favorite word. And I'm indeed originally from the Czech Republic, from Prague. I have lived in the States for about 20 years and started my company about 5 years ago. So welcome again. I am going to tell you just a little bit about my process, and then I'm going to show you how you can style my scarves, one of which I'm wearing right now, so that it fits really well into your lifestyle. So I like to think about what I do as stories in fabrics. I love literature, I love traveling, I love looking around the world for stories that really move me. So the textiles you see behind me are all kind of visual interpretations of a moment in my life. It can be a big moment, it can be a tiny moment, and I'll just kind of tell you a few of the stories of the scarves behind me. All of the textiles you see have a name, and they come with a short little story of inspiration that explains how I have created the design. So I'm going to start with the design that I'm wearing right now. This is a scarf called Ceiling, and it is actually a photograph of the ceiling at the American Art Museum in Washington, D.C. It is a really cool Smithsonian institution, and they have actually carried the scarf at the gift shop over there for a few years now. The scarf is all about kind of looking up, seeing the bigger picture. I love the ceiling at the museum. It's beautiful, and I think that the photo that I have taken has created a really cool, interesting black and white design. It kind of goes with anything. So this is a story about kind of keeping an open mindset as you go through your world. I'm going to show you a story that's kind of the opposite of this one. It is this scarf right here. This scarf is called a raindrop, and it is based on a photo of a tiny, tiny raindrop after a storm in Costa Rica. And the story here is the opposite. It's all about pausing and seeing kind of the fine details of life so that you can really enjoy them and let them bring you joy. Another example would be this scarf. This scarf is called Show Off Like a Peacock. And it's a watercolor painting I have done after a trip to my hometown, which would be Prague in the Czech Republic. My mom and I went for a walk at a public garden where they have free roaming peacocks. And we came home, my mom was taking a nap, and I ended up painting the peacock in kind of like a really abstracted manner. So the scarf, the story about it is kind of this moment of the peacock opening up the tail and really kind of showing the beauty. So I do hope that when you wear it, you feel like you can trust the world, be vulnerable, and really show kind of who you are. Another example of a story might be this one. So this scarf is called Salty Watercolor, and it is based on an abstract watercolor. I painted in lovely greens and blues, and then I put in kitchen salt. So all of the little details that you see are crystals of salt that have kind of fused in. Let me put the scarf back out. So the story of this one is, again, kind of trust in life and being able to let it mix the way it needs to. You know, I had an idea for the painting itself, but once I put the salt crystals in, everything just kind of happened without my being able to control it. And I did enjoy that. So I hope you can find moments in life where you can let go and enjoy the moment. So that's just a few examples of kind of the stories behind my scarves. The stories range from pieces inspired by travel, random life moments, to, you know, kind of mantras, something that I, when I put the scarf around my neck, I really need it. I want it to support my day. I want to go through my day with my, you know, with my back straight and strong. So I'm going to now show you a few ways that you can style the scarves. I make the scarves in two shapes. It's either an infinity scarf, which you can see here, kind of a closed off circle, or I make them as a rectangle, which means they're just gonna open up and you can knot them in the front. So one way to wear the scarves is to just really put it around your neck like this. If you are wearing a jacket, it just kind of fakes a blouse, and you can, you know, wear a basic t-shirt like I'm wearing right now, and you're all set. Most of my customers wear the scarves doubled over, which means you just kind of twist it around, put it around your neck, and then you style it whichever way you want to. You can see on me that you get a little bit of volume, but not too much. The scarves are really lightweight, you can wash them, they're really easy to take care of. The third way to style it is really once you have the doubled knot, you can pull it down and kind of create a more of a cascading, elongated look. I do have some customers who will put a pin over here, which I think is a really great way, or they put a pin here. So if you like pins and you want to kind of style the scarf with your jewelry, go for it. It's a lot of fun. The last kind of styling tip I'll give you is you are able, with especially with the infinity scarf, to make a little bit of a knot. I like this styling especially for when I'm wearing turtlenecks. I think it's really fun to just kind of have the chest kind of closed up with your turtleneck peeking up around here, around your chin, and then having this kind of little cascading knot. I think that's just, this is kind of very simple and stylish, and you do get some warmth around your neck, but also kind of a sense of more of an elongated look. So that's the four ways I would suggest that you wear the scarves. I have seen my clients do all kinds of stuff, again, adding pins. They mix two scarves together, one black and white one and one of the more colorful ones. They mix it up and create more of a volume if you need it, especially for the warmer months. I wear the scarves throughout the year. I wear them for sun protection in the summer with a simple tank top. I wear them with dresses, with turtlenecks, as I mentioned already. So you really have kind of endless ways of wearing them. So that's a little bit about me, about my designs, and about what you can do with the scarves. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for visiting me in my studio in Kensington. I do hope you get a chance to visit my website and read more about the stories behind my designs. Before I sign off, I do want to give a little shout out to a dear friend of mine named Ruth. She is a jewelry designer in Silver Spring, Maryland, and she's my fellow crafter. I am wearing her earrings, so I'm gonna just kind of get a little closer in so you can see them. They're wonderful, I love them, and you can see they go perfectly with my scarf. So again, thanks Ruthie for your beautiful design. Check out Ruthie's designs under her brand, which is Ruthie Lawn Jewelry, and she's on Instagram. So thank you again for visiting. This is again Martina. I invite you to take a look at my work, and I hope to hear from you. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.